So today we'll discuss about the second lecture of HVDC and FET. So now in this lecture we'll discuss the principle of power conversion. How the HVDC station or converter station convert the power AC power into DC power, and same as at the receiving end the DC power into AC power. So there are types of converters available for converting AC into DC. First we will see the how we convert AC power into DC power. So there are different types of converter available. Types of converter for AC to DC power converter. Number 8, in case of single phase, first half wave controlled converter full wave controlled converter. In case of three phase, there are also one center tip type converter is also available, but in case of three phase, and also full wave control converter, semi converter type. These are the main types of converters available for converting AC into DC. We will see first the single phase full wave control converter, and thereafter we will see about the three phase full wave control converter. Single phase full wave control converter. Now this is the schematic diagram of single phase full wave converter. This is the single phase supply source, single phase AC supply. This is a transformer. Say 1:1 or unity transformer. These are the SCRs named as T1, T2, T3, T4. This is a load, say resistive load. Current flowing through the load, say I. This is the secondary side of the transformer. Primary side of transformer. Current flowing through the secondary winding of transformer is IS. So this is a schematic diagram of single phase full wave control converter having 4 SCRs and resistive load connected to it. Now how the AC is converted into DC, alternating current is converted into direct current. This is an AC voltage waveform. Vm is the maximum power, so this is 0, pi, 2 pi, 3 pi. This is V input, V output. Now, when the firing angle alpha is 0 degree, firing angle or trailing angle, alpha is equal to 0 degree. So, say the first half of AC supply is fed to the converter. This point, say A, this is say B. So when the positive half cycle is fed to the converter circuit and say A is positive with respect to B, at this particular instant SCR T1 and T2 are in forward blocking mode and T3 and T4 are reverse bias condition. Why these T1 and T2 are in forward blocking mode? Because as we know that the anode of the SCR is positive with respect to cathode, same as here, anode is positive with respect to cathode. So they are in the forward blocking mode and as soon as they will get a firing pulse, they turn their state from forward blocking mode to the conduction state. Now, as we chosen firing angle alpha is equal to 0 degree, so at this particular instant, say omega t is equal to 0, at this particular instant, I will apply firing pulses to both the SCR, so they will conduct and the current from the secondary of the transformer will flow from this path. From the secondary winding to SCR T1, load RL, T2 and back. So, say the load terminal X to Y, the current is now flowing from X to Y in the load circuit. And the nature of the current is the same as the input voltage. Because these SCRs are acting as a switch. These are the power semiconductor switches. When in forward blocking mode, they are open circuited. As soon as the firing pulse applied to the these forward blocking SCR, they will conduct and and we can say the switches are now closed and current is flowing from T1 R to T2 and back. So the load is now connected to the source. Whatever voltage are supplied at the source now is connected to the load, and we will get this type of output voltage. Now, at omega t is equal to pi, now the supply voltage is changes from positive to negative. Supply changes from positive to negative. Hence, the polarity at point A and B will become, this become negative and this become positive. As soon as the polarity reverses, the SCRs T1 and T2 now come to the reverse bias condition, and T3 and T4, as you can see here, that terminal B is now positive and the anode is connected to the to this terminal which is positive, and cathode of T4 is connected to the negative terminal. Hence T3 and T4 are now in forward blocking mode, and as soon as the firing pulse is applied to this particular SCR, they conduct, they change their state from the forward blocking mode to the conduction state, and now the current from the source to load will flow from this particular path, from the secondary winding of transformer to T3 load, T4 and back. So by this way you can see, the direction of current is same as when SCR T1 and T2 are conducting. So the direction of current in the load is always from X to Y. Hence the voltage polarity at the load side will the same as the previous one. So now the output voltage waveform will appear like this. At this instant the input is of negative nature, negative half cycle, but at load side will get this particular output voltage waveform. Hence from here once again at omega t is equal to 2 pi, once again the polarity will change, this will become positive, this become negative, and hence SCR T3, T4 which was conducting state now come to the reverse bias condition, and T1 and T2 which was on reverse bias condition now on forward blocking mode, and as soon as the supply, as soon as the firing pulse is applied to these SCR, they will conduct and will get this type of waveform. This is the simplest type of converter, single phase full wave AC controlled converter having firing angle alpha is equal to 0. Now, if we change the firing angle from 0 to say 30 degree, from 0 to 30 degree, then what will happen? Now, at omega t, say, positive half cycle is applied to the converter circuit. So, A is positive with respect to B, T1 and T2 are in forward blocking mode, but now we are giving firing pulses to these SCR on alpha is equal to 30 degree, say somewhat here. This is the alpha 30 degree. Now what happened? From 0 to alpha, SCR T1 and T2 are in forward blocking mode, SCR T3 and T4 are in reverse bias, and hence load is disconnected from the source, so nothing will available at the load side. Our output voltage will be zero. We can say there will be no operation. At alpha is equal to 30 degree, firing angle 30 degree, firing pulses are applied to SCR T1 and T2. They start conducting and the source is now connected to the load through T1, load T2, and will get output voltage like this. Same in the negative half cycle of the supply. Negative half cycle of the supply at omega t is equal to pi, the supply is now reverses. Supply is now reverses. T1, T2 will become reverse bias. T3, T4 will now in forward blocking mode, but will give firing pulses at this particular instant, which is omega t is equal to 180 plus 30 degree, which is 210 degree. At omega t is equal to 210 degree, SCR T3, T4 will get firing pulse and then start conducting, and the source is now connected to the load through this T3, T4, SCR, and the current will flow from source to T3 to T4 and back, and will get output voltage like this. So this is the output voltage available at the load, resistive load, when the alpha is equal to 30 degree. Say we can change the firing angle from 0 to 180 degree. One more firing angle we can see, that is alpha is equal to 120 degree. In this case, we'll give firing pulses somewhat here. Firing pulses somewhat here. So the output voltage will get like this. So this is the output voltage available to the load or resistive load. So by changing the firing angle, we can change the output voltage available to the load. This is for the resistive load. Now if we change the load from resistive to inductive load, then what will happen? Now the load will change from resistive to inductive load. Input voltage will same. Input voltage is same, single phase full wave, positive half, negative half, applied to the converter circuit which is connected to an load, say RL load, and if we will say firing angle, say alpha is equal to 30 degree. Alpha is equal to 30 degree. Now, same at when the positive half cycle is applied to the converter circuit at omega t, T1 and T2 will become will change from off state to forward blocking state. T3, T4 is in reverse bias condition, and as soon as will give a firing pulse at alpha is equal to 30 degree or omega t is equal to 30 degree, this will start conducting and the current will flow from source to T1 to the RL load and T2 and back. So the positive half cycle will be, the output voltage at positive half cycle will show like this. Now at omega t is equal to pi, as soon as the supply will positive half will change to the negative half or negative second half of supply come to the converter circuit, this will become negative, this will become positive. Now at this instant these SCR T1 and T2 will not come into the reverse bias mode because of the presence of this inductor. As the in the positive half cycle, this inductor accumulates some energy. Now, as soon as the negative half cycle applies to the converter circuit, what will happen? These energy which is accumulated by the inductor will now discharge its energy and the current will flow from this inductor to T2 from secondary of the transformer, T1 and the load. At this instant we assume that the transformer is lossless. So what happened? In previous case, when the load is of resistive nature, at omega t is equal to pi, the SCR T1 T2 comes from the conducting state to the reverse bias condition. But due to the presence of inductor, these SCRs will not directly come from conduction state to the reverse bias conditions unless until the charge or the energy accumulated by the inductor will disappear, and it will lose the energy is lost by this way from the inductor to T2 to the secondary of the transformer, T1 and load. So energy is dissipated here only. Other things will take as an ideal or lossless. So now from we say we assume that from pi to pi plus alpha, from pi to pi plus alpha, this inductor dissipates its energy through SCR T1 and T2. So during this time these SCRs will in conduction state, and as they are the switches, power semiconductor switches, as I told you earlier, these are the power semiconductor switches. So as the switches are closed during pi to pi plus alpha, the source is connected to the load. The source is connected to the load, hence the supply at source side will appear at load side. And at load side will get these negative half cycle. This is small negative half cycle. It will depend upon the value of inductor. We assume that when we fire the SCRs T3 T4 at omega t is equal to pi plus alpha, at this instant inductor dissipates all its energy. Now at this instant omega t is equal to pi plus alpha, as the inductor dissipates its energy, T1 T2 will now come into the reverse bias condition, T3 T4 which come into the forward blocking mode, and at the same time they will get the firing pulse and they will now start conducting, and the source is now connected to the load through T3, R, L, T4 and back, and hence the current flowing through the load, RL load, is this, the direction of current is same as the previous one from X to Y, and will get an output voltage like this. This is a four quadrant. Say current I on x-axis, voltage on y is minus 9, minus minus V. The single phase full wave control converter will work in two quadrants. First, if the firing angle, say the firing angle alpha, if the firing angle alpha is in between 0 to 90 degree, if the firing angle from 0 to 90 degree, the output voltage of the converter, single phase full wave converter, is having the positive polarity, and the current is from source to load, as we see in 0 degree and 30 degree. You can say the average output voltage is positive as compared to these small negative voltages. So if the firing angle is in between 0 to 90 degree, the voltage polarity is positive across the load. This type of operation is known as conversion operation. So if the firing angle is from 0 to 90 degree, the output voltage is positive, the current is positive, hence it will work in this particular quadrant, say quadrant 1. See, quadrant first, and this is second quadrant, this is third quadrant, and this is fourth quadrant. Now, if we change the firing from 90 degree to 180 degree, 90 degree to 180 degree, the output voltage will become negative, or average output voltage will become negative, but the current will still flow from the source to load. Hence, you can say that if the firing angle is in this range, 90 to 180 degree, the output voltage polarity across the load of single phase full wave control converter is negative, but the current is still positive. Hence, it will operate in this particular region where the current is positive and voltage is negative. When the firing angle is from 0 to 90 degree, from 90 degree to 180 degree, this is known as conversion mode operation, this is known as inversion mode operation. Please keep in mind that this is inversion mode operation and this is conversion mode operation. So, with the use of single phase full wave converter or full wave converter, we will get positive polarity as well as negative polarity just by changing the firing angle from 0 to 90 or from 90 to 180. So this is the operation and schematic diagram and output voltage waveform of single phase full wave controlled converter. Now, in case of HVDC, we use the power semiconductor, say SCRs, for the switching purpose, because the typical voltage range and current of SCR as compared to other power semiconductor devices is very high. Hence, for the conversion of AC to DC, in case of HVDC, we prefer SCR. There are various types of SCR, but in case of SCR, there is one special purpose SCR named as LASCR, that is known as light activated silicon controlled rectifier, SCR is used. So this is the conversion of AC to DC in case of single phase with the help of single phase full wave control controller.